Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will learn how we can create an animation of a blob by using a simple sphere and a couple of tricks using the material system on the spline. So you can see here I can rotate and see different point of views of this blob animation, which looks really really nice. And we will see how we can create these sort of animations using a spline and the transition systems. Alright, let's begin. Okay, so the first step is to create a sphere. So I'm going to click here on the top icon, and then I'm going to click and drag to create a sphere, and I want to make sure that the units are in 400 in all axes for the size parameter here. Then I'm going to delete this rectangle because I don't need it, and then I'm just going to right click on the sphere and press on reset all, so I make sure that the sphere is right on the middle. Alright, I just need to start changing a little bit the colors. So for the background, I'm going to change it to a brighter background. I'm actually going to use this color because I already have it. And then I want to start adding deformation to the sphere, right? So the first thing is that I'm going to create a displace layer here, and already you can see that the sphere is getting deformed. So I want to increase the intensity to be 100, so it's a lot more higher now. Instead of 10 in the scale, I actually want to use 3.7, and instead of 1 in movement, I want to use 20. Now I want to start working on the colors for the sphere. So the first thing is that I'm going to change the lighting to be an overlay and the opacity to be 30. Then the base color, I also want it to be a little brighter, something like that. And now I want to add a depth layer, and this depth layer is going to use a bluish color as the base one here, and then I'm going to copy this color and going to paste it in this other place, and I'm going to change the alpha. Then I'm going to change the sliders in here, so I want this bluish color to be something like this, and I'm going to change it to be smooth, so the smooth interpolation looks a lot more natural. So you can see, you can barely actually see the borders of this object because it's almost the same as the background, right? So now I'm just going to duplicate this layer by right clicking on the icon here and pressing duplicate, and then by clicking again, now I want to move it to be somewhere around here. I just want to change the radius to be something like this, and the color in this case is gonna be something like yellow, right? Something like this, and then the same color on the other side. And now I just want to duplicate it again a couple of times, and this is gonna be here, and then in the last case it's going to be somewhere around here. Now for the one in this side, I want to use turquoise, something like this, and so I want this to be something like the same color in here as well, and then the alpha is going to be like that. And then finally for the last one, it's going to be a pink color. Then just copy here and paste it here. All right, we are almost there. The only thing that we're missing is that I think the brightness needs to be a little higher in here, so it feels a little better, something like that. And then we can just adjust the colors a little bit, so maybe a little bit more like this, and then perhaps the yellow could be a little bit more like this, so we can see more of the white color. And then also the green could be a little more to the border. Perhaps the blue can be less intense as well, something like this. I guess the final step would be to animate this deformation, right? So one thing that we can do is that we can create another state in here, and in this state we can change the movement to be 400 instead. And here in the events we can create a start event, and then here for the duration of this event it could be 40 seconds. And then the transition needs to be linear, so this way we know that it's going to be a constant change. Alright, it seems like we're ready, so let's go to the play mode now. And that is it. You can see how the sphere is mutating and deforming. A bunch of things that you can do from here is, like, for example, you can change the display scale. So let's see, for example, maybe it starts like more like deeper, and then when you play it kind of like gets more soft over time, so that's something that you can try. If you have like a lot of like complexity here, you can also increase the subdivision level. So maybe, for example, if you increase subdivision level, you can see how it feels a little bit more soft in the edges versus the way it was before, right? All right, I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.